Double honors to the elders and apostles of Gwildstone, or Jolaram to the wandered Israelites, which include Judah's children, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Indians, who are oppressed together, according to Jeremiah 50 and 33. But to whom pertained the adoption, the giving of the law, the promises, the glory, and the covenants, according to Romans chapter 9, opposed to the foreign teachings, which according to Revelation 14 and 4 represent the defilement by a foreign woman. May the kingdom of everlasting life and joy, the secrets be revealed unto you as blood descendants of Jacob, whose name was later changed to Israel, scattered to the four winds of the earth, as a people first, man. Alright, okay. So you have basically New York, okay, over here where 300,000 households, alright, flee since May, okay, or April or something, okay. And this is anyway, you know, not our West here, alright. So let me start before we read that article with the verse of today, because it's basically the topic, man. Instead, they were longing for a better country, alright, a heavenly one. Therefore, God Elohim is not ashamed to be called their God, Elohim, for he has prepared a city for them. Hebrews 11 and 16, you see. So basically, we have no, country here, alright, we have no town, no place here, alright, especially in so-called America, because this is the main captivity place of the real Hebrew Israelites, alright, you know, systematic oppression, and before that, physical oppression, alright. Escape from New York, 300,000 households flee as lockdowns, you see, because the second lockdown is coming, and surging crime saw residents, alright. Roughly 300,000 households have moved out of New York City since March, fleeing a metropolis that has become a land of lockdowns and rising violent crime in a year dominated by the COVID-19 pandemic and civil unrest. U.S. Postal Service data obtained by the New York Post showed that there were more than 259,000 change of address requests, you see, filled by residents moving out of the city's five boroughs from March 1 to October 31. The data included only moves to counties with 11 or more forwarding requests filed, meaning relocations to places where 10 or fewer New Yorkers moved during the period weren't counted. Each change of address request typically covers a whole household, not just an individual, you see. So the number of people moving would be higher than the number of filings. There were nearly 254,000 moving notices filled with the Postal Service in March, July alone. The Post said up to 101,000 a year earlier. The exodus has been blamed on COVID-19 concerns, economic growth, rising crime, and troubled schools. Alright, guests are coming to your Thanksgiving. New York Governor Cuomo whipped for new draconian COVID-19 restrictions. Alright, so really in these towns, man, alright, it's, you know, really getting started there, alright. So the people already moved out at the first lockdown, alright, but the second will be worse, alright, and you have the stock window, Jacob's trouble coming up, alright, which is actually... Jacob's trouble is the end of this wicked rulership, basically, alright. New York State has suffered more than 33,000 COVID-19 deaths. You know, like, deaths that can basically happen, you know, they could die of anything, but they say it's COVID-19, alright. So if they have somebody dying, alright, even if he dies of cancer, they said they put on the paper, they put on COVID-19, okay? The most in the nation, you know, they need these numbers, of course, also, alright? And more than 24,000 were in New York, okay? And again, we don't say that there's no virus. The city has had some of the most stringent economic lockdowns in the country to deter the spread of the virus, leading to thousands of restaurants, shops, and other firms going out of business. New York is also among many large U.S. cities that have been rocked by Black Lives Matter, by Two Dirts, basically, protests and violent Antifa Two Dirts, riots and looting in the aftermath of George Floyd's death in Minneapolis, police custody in May. Manhattan Institute poll, taken from July 13th to August 3, showed that 44% of New Yorkers who make more than $100,000 annually had considered moving out of the city since March. Alright, so of course, you know, we should be like pilgrims in these days, alright. You know, anything can happen at any moment right now. Alright, I just can't repeat the borders. Okay. You know, if you're in a town, of course you try to move out, alright, because the towns also will catch bad cases, you know, but anyway, you know, basically, you know, the ones who don't die by famine, alright, which will happen in the cities, of course, most likely, you know, will die by the sword, okay? So basically, you know, you can't flee, alright, you have to think about it, alright, if it's, in certain cases, better to live on the land, you know, the border from Tanzania, for example, alright, you know, Tanzania is different also than Germany, alright, and Germany is different than Babylon the Great War, USA somewhere, alright, so they are different, alright, lots where you basically were scattered to, man, alright, so you have to think, you know, before you basically, okay, move, and also you have to meditate on basically being a pilgrim, okay, what that means, alright, again, as I said in my last video, alright, it's not, you know, it's not according to wisdom, man, alright, if you just, you know, if you make yourself more stressed with actually moving somewhere, alright, you know, when, you know, when you could actually wait and maybe move later, man, alright, so there are many things that you have to think also and meditate also on, if you, you know, you, if you want to use wisdom, man, alright, okay, let's say it like that, man, if I move to Turkey now, alright, what does it benefit me, man, alright, so you have to, you know, so you see, so using wisdom is way, you know, is way deeper than, you know, than normal people would read this, alright, being a pilgrim in these days, alright, then the one dirt will read this, okay, because the one dirt will have protection, okay, other people who read this verse and have no wisdom will have no protection when they're not Hebrew Israelites, and the one dirts, okay, so basically that's it, man, you see, okay, New York State has suffered more than, okay, the city has had some of the most stringent economic lockdowns in the country to deter the spread of the virus, leading thousands of restaurants, shops and other firms going out of business. New York is also among many large US cities that have been rocked by Black Lives Matter. Okay, riots and looting in the aftermath of George Floyd's death. Okay, so basically, these middle class people are white. The next lockdown is a killer, man. Alright, nearly two-thirds said they believed present conditions were a new normal for the city. Respondents said their quality of life had deteriorated and their satisfaction with the city dropped by half, okay? Okay, but the satisfaction with the city, okay, and all America and all around the four corners of the earth, man, the four winds of the earth, man, alright, it will be satisfaction minus, man, alright, not even 0%, man, you see, that will be the satisfaction, man, alright, because what is coming, alright, is Yahweh using that devil, alright, to bring that dark window of the microchip and special, alright, and then the missiles will drop, man, alright, and then, you know, Yahweh will crack them clouds and will come back and bring the kingdom, man. Alright, our actually dwelling place, man. Alright, the dwelling place of you wandered Israelites, the elect, man. Alright, starting with us, hopefully, alright, you know, with me, hopefully, also, you see. The law of supply and demand also illustrates the growing desire to get out of New York City, to enter 20-foot U-Haul truck on December 4 to move from New York to Nashville, Tennessee would cost $2,153, according to the company's website. To make the same move in reverse on that same date, the truck rental would cost $677, or less than one-third the weight to leave New York. Okay. NYT columnist goes for a jog, sees no mayhem, and declares that New York's alleged surge in crime is a non-existent crisis. Okay. As for violent crime, there were 344 murders in New York from January to September, exceeding the total of 335 for all of 2019, with 3 months still remaining to go in 2020. The number of shootings has risen to 94%. Okay, and I think even that there is a scripture that talks about he that is in the city, man. Okay. Okay. I don't talk about the elect, because the elect's life is in the hand of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, alright? Talk about the two dot and heathen's life, okay? He that is in the city, alright, you see? King James Version, let's get it real quick. I don't remember where what it exactly says, but maybe there is it, alright? And it came to pass, blessed is he that the Lord, you see? Blessed be the Lord, alright? For he has made marvelous his loving kindness to me in a besieged city, man. You see? So this is interesting, man. Okay, but this is not what we're looking for. You see? This is really actually difficult when it's about the Apocrypha, alright? Because I think it's in the Apocrypha, actually. But they're interesting verses, of course. You saw that, alright? 67 verses about the city, alright? There's even a scripture that talks about there is one with wisdom in the city, and the city shall be delivered, man. But they don't remember him, man. Alright? So it can be that your city, basically, you know that there will be some differences, alright? According to other cities, man. Compared to other cities, man, in some cases, because there dwelt people with wisdom in it, man. Alright? Just remember Lot, man. Alright? Not Lot, man, alright, this was, I believe, Abraham, alright, who said, who basically, alright, talked with Yahweh, alright, about not to destroy the city, because, you know, at least this few person dwell in there, man, alright, and then he said, will you also destroy the city, or the place, alright, when only one righteous is dwelling there, I believe, something like that, alright, but it's hard to find it, but I will look for it, man, okay, I have to pause the video then, also, of course, alright, but I want to show you that also, okay, he that is in the city, or that is in the city, and let's get it, that is in the city, okay, and we will find it because it's in the Apocrypha. In the KingJam.S, alright, which contains the Apocrypha 1611 King James Version, okay, has of course these books in here because they are part of the Bible, alright. Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Hosea, alright. So let's get it, man. Alright, Tobit, alright. See, you know, scripture says also, as the ruler of places, you know, the people are just basically like these people, all right, on the top, man. Okay, so there are many scriptures about the cities, and you know, cities, man. Okay, so basically, you know, he that is in the city, okay, he that is in the city. Salah, okay. But anyway, man, alright, I'm just looking for that scripture real quick, alright. So, you know, pretty much it's Genesis 18 and 21, 22. Alright, Zalachia, of course it was Abraham, and you know, Lot, pretty much, alright, who dwelt in Sodom, alright, you know, Zalachia. Of course they were, alright. So basically, he negotiated with Yahweh, man, okay, because the word here with who he has negotiated with is Yahweh, man, the existing one, alright. Alright, the god of this universe, man. Alright, this is deep, man, okay. You know, you had Moses talking with Yahweh, basically, alright, but here you have basically him negotiating with Yahweh, man, that shows you that righteous seed line is Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. But, you know, if you only of Abraham, it's not enough, alright, because the blessing was given to Jacob, and also not to Isaac, alright. You have Esau, the most wicked of the wicked, coming out of Isaac also, man. So of course it is to the father seed line, but of course it's also to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, because Jacob is the one where the 12 tribes came to, man. You see, to his sperm, man. Alright, so basically, alright, if you're not part of the 12 tribes, alright, you're not a part of, again, alright, according to Romans chapter 9, there's no salvation for you, man. Alright, no adoption, no giving of the law, no promises, alright, no promises, no glory, okay, no kingdom, alright, but slavery, alright, and the covenants, of course, alright, the covenants, alright, plural, covenants, okay, all made with Israel, and Israel, alright, is Jacob, alright. So we will read from 22, and the man turned their faces from thence. No heathens in the Bible, you know, just say it like that. And went towards Sodom, but Abraham stood yet before Yahweh. Okay, and Abraham knew and said, wilt thou also destroy the righteous with the wicked? You see, because they were dwelling there, man. Alright, peradventure, alright, of course it was destroyed after that, but you know, you know, he will look for his elect, man, wherever they were scattered to, man. Alright, and if you know that scripture, alright, I will pull it out then, man. Alright. By wisdom, one delivered the city or something is written, alright. You know, but you know, everywhere will be famine and the sword again, alright. You know, peradventure there will be 50 righteous within the city. Will they also destroy and not spare the place for the 50 righteous that are therein? Alright, this is heavy, man. That be far from thee to do after this manner, to slay the righteous with the wicked, and that the righteous should be as the wicked. That before from thee shall not the judge of all the earth do what? See? And Yahweh said, if I find at Sodom in Sodom 50 righteous within the city, then I will spare all the place for their sakes. Okay. And Abraham answered and said, behold, now I have taken upon me to speak unto the Lord Yahweh, which am but dust and ashes. See? So he considered that he is just dust and ashes, just like Job. This is, of course, you know, important, okay? Peradventure, there shall lack 5 of the 50 righteous, alright? Those people who understand that also, but that they are actually only dust and ashes, okay? Will thou destroy all the city for lack of 5? And he said, if I find there 40 and 5, I will not destroy it. And he spake unto him yet again and said, peradventure, there shall be 40 found there. And he said, I will not do it for 40's sake. And he said unto him, oh, let not the Lord be angry, Yahweh, and I will speak peradventure there shall 30 be found there. And he said, I will not do it if I find 30 there. Alright, so he was continuing that, man. Alright. And he said, behold now, you know, that shows you that Yahweh, alright, he is you know, he has more you know, understanding of you know, he's not like a power that don't knows, alright, where you live, how you live, and what hell you catch as an Israelite, man. Alright, he understands even more aspects to your life than you yourself, alright, and he even knows yourself better than you, alright, that's Yahweh, okay? But what, man, you know, because of Abraham, they were delivered, alright, because he had to basically negotiate with him, man, alright? Okay, we don't know how it would happen, alright, if he did not do that, alright, okay, because, again, they were righteous, okay, But what we know is, man, alright, that the story was already written again, and Yahweh already had it before the earth was created, that Abraham would pretty much negotiate with him, you see? So that's Yahweh, and he knows every, you know, just go by that, man. If something does exist, you know, like a hair on your head, man, or just a little, you know, let's get it real quick, alright? If something exists, you know, it's there because of Yahweh, pretty much, did it so, alright? If there's a dust on the ground, okay, or a dust, alright, where I'm here now, okay, right before me, alright, it's because Yahweh wanted it to be there, okay? That's Yahweh, man, okay? So, of course, he already had that before, alright, before Abraham did it, he already wanted him to do it, alright, because there was no free will according to the scriptures, alright? Listen to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, they told you that, alright, there is no free will, man. Alright, you were chosen from birth, again. If you are of the one dirt, man. But you were also chosen to be a two dirt, for example, also, okay? Or to be a heathen, alright? Or to be, you know, everything, man. Okay? So again, I will not destroy it for 20's sake, okay? 32, and he said, oh, let the Lord Yahweh be angry, and I will speak yet but this once. Peradventure 10 shall be found there, and he said, I will not destroy it for 10's. And the Lord Yahweh went his way as soon as he had left commuting with Abraham, and Abraham returned unto his place, okay? So this is really, okay, because here in chapter 19 you read about, and there came two angels to Sodom and Eve, and Lot sat in the gate of Sodom, and Lot, seeing them, was up to meet them, and he bowed himself with his face toward the ground. And he said, behold, now my lord's turn, I pray you, alright, into your servant's house, and tarry all night, and wash your feet, and you shall rise up early, and go on your ways. And they said, nay, but we will abide in the street all night. And he pressed upon the greatly, and turned in unto him, and entered into his house, and he made them a feast, okay, and did bake unleavened bread, and they did eat, okay? So basically, even the people, these wicked people out of the city, they came to his house, basically, alright, and wanted to pretty much sodomite this angel, alright? That's how wicked the city was, man. If you go everywhere where Esau is dwelling right now, you will have that also, you see? So that's, again, the proof that you have to understand these verses, alright? You know, somebody is delivering a city by his wisdom. Understand that, alright, with wisdom, okay? You have to understand that with wisdom also, okay? Because this time, everywhere will hit the famine, man, alright? You know, every last one of them, alright, will catch their righteous judgment, okay? The heathens for what they did for us, and the two dwellers for what they did to Yahweh, alright? Basically snitching, alright? You can't snitch on Yahweh, alright? Because, he already chose you, alright, to be that wicked and to be destroyed, okay? But again, alright? It will come to a city near you, okay? It will come to a place near you where you're dwelling, man. He that is in the field, man, you see? In the field? That's the spirit, man, because that's what I was searching for, man, alright? He that is in the field, man, okay? What, okay? What? Okay, let's get it real quick, man. But first, Luke 17 and 31, real quick, in that day, you see? He will, because we in these last days, alright, we in the last days of the last days, man, alright, anything can happen right now, man. He which shall up on the housetop and the stuff in the house, let him not come back down to take it away. And he that is in the field, let him likewise not return back. Wherever you are, man, don't return, don't look back even, man, alright. Remember Lot's wife, man, that's the topic also, you know. Lot's wife, guess what, man, alright, she turned into a statue of salt, man, for looking back only, man, okay? But of course he want them to not look back, okay? You see, and we also want today to not look back, man, okay? And this is Ezekiel 7 and 15. The sword is without, and the pestilence, and the famine within. Alright, he that is in the field shall die with the sword, and he that is in the city, famine and pestilence shall devour him, man. See, so that's basically the point, man, okay? You see? Let's get to the also real quick, the other one, alright. Alright. By wisdom, alright? By wisdom. Deliberate city. Or something like that. Gone. Ecclesiastes 9 and 15. Now there was found in it a poor wise man, and he, by his wisdom, delivered the city. Alright? Yet no man remembered that same pure man, you see. Okay. So we of course know what that means, alright? Okay, I told you about that in the beginning of the video. As for the violent crime, they were, the post said most of the following addresses are nearby locales, such as New Jersey and neighboring New York counties, but more than 13,000 households moved to three counties in Florida, and nearly 9,000 redirected their mail to Los Angeles. Governor Andrew Cuomo's efforts to urge wealthy New Yorkers to move back to the city apparently have had little effect. More than 60,000 Manhattan apartments sat vacant as of October, the most in 14 years. Cuomo announced new COVID-19 restrictions on Wednesday, prohibiting gatherings of more than 10 people in homes and requiring restaurants and bars to close by 10 p.m. So we have these light restrictions in Germany also, alright, and they talk about it's not getting better and so on, you know. And playing with these numbers, of course. And again, man, he that dies by the sword is better, okay? Dies by the sword better than those who die of famine, man, okay? You see? Salah. He does for alright. So of course pestilences will be everywhere, man. Okay. Quick, better die. Okay, sword. Okay. But you know that scripture, okay? He that dies by the sword is better than he that died by hunger. All right. He that dies by the sword is better than he that dies by hunger. King James Version. Okay, we will get that. Bear with me, Akion. Those slain by the sword are better off. Alright, Lamentations 4 and 9. Okay. This is true, man. You think that's written for for entertainment? No, man. All these people that think that this is entertainment here, alright. Let's look how entertainment it is when it comes upon you, man. They that be slain with the sword are better than they that be slain with hunger, you see? For these pine away, stricken too for want of the fruits of the field. Alright, and again, man, hunger is a really, you know, harsh way, man. Especially if you have these people, alright, around you that basically, you know, eat each other up, man. So you have even Esau putting out these movies about cannibalism, alright? And you better believe, man, that friends will turn against one another, man, alright? Because they even would eat their kids, alright? How much more? Alright, you have that example. Let us eat your child and tomorrow my child, alright? These were two women, man. This is talking about Israelite women, but they will be just like the beast in these times as they are now. And when I say these times, I talk actually about the next days, man. Alright, about these last seconds in this wicked rulership. Alright, in this hell. Alright, because I will close out today with the place for the one dirt elect, starting with them. Alright, and you know, I will close out with that. Khan, Lamentations 4 and 10. The hands of the pitiful woman have sodden their own children. And did Eden, alright, the same ones who said, "Where's thy God?" Alright, she will, you know. And I said unto her on the next day, "Give thy son, that we may eat him." And she had hid her son. Some have supposed that that woman considered a child. Okay, this is another example, but that's not what I'm looking for. Khan, but you know that scripture, right? Where the one woman says to the other one, "If it's not dead, then we will not eat him." Next day. Alright, you know. Something upon that lines, you know. Like, today we eat yours and then we eat mine. It isn't that, you know? Okay? Because you have this, stupid translations here. Okay. So let's get it real quick, alright, because I want to close out really with a really, really beautiful scripture, alright. But I have to translate it in the German, from the German tongue real quick first, alright. Keine bleibende Städte in Deutsch sozusagen. No permanent place. No. We have a really. What is it? In the King James Version, we have a very noble Englishman. Alright. So, of course, I know that. No permanent place. Alright, for we look for okay. Hebrews, Khan, it's Hebrews, that's what I knew, okay, but it's Hebrews 13 and 14. Hebrews 13 and 14. For here have we not a continuing city, but we seek one to come. Alright? We're righteousnesses, man. Okay, so again, if you have to move, if you have to be homeless, even in the upcoming times. Okay, of course you have to endure. Okay, and of course, alright. Pretty much. Alright, this is what we're looking for, man. Alright, to be in these times, man. Alright, to bring the kingdom in, man. Alright, this will bring our kingdom in, man. Being homeless, being a pilgrim, man. Being, you know, this and that, man. Okay. And with that, all praises to Yahweh, Ba'asham, Yahweh Shai, Ba'asham, Kakadash. Alright, and hopefully we see us in the next video. Shalom to the elect. I'm out of here. Shalom.